Switching to no-plow farming is very beneficial, especially from the perspective of farmers who are struggling with drought. No-plow farming is effective on any type of soil, but many growers believe it is not such a simple solution. Questions arise that are difficult to answer unequivocally. How will plants react to simplified cultivation? Will giving up the plow bring more losses than benefits? What about pests and weeds that will appear in the field? Undecided farmers seek answers and are torn between facts and myths, of which there are many on this topic. This material will dispel all doubts. The eternal dilemma of every farmer: how to harness the potential of the field and provide plants with the best access to nutrients, air, and water. It is always necessary to deeply loosen the soil to achieve the best results. Well, no. A different approach to the topic, namely simplifications in the soil cultivation, is currently the best and most recommended solution. Although no-plow farming is a great way to reduce field operations while reducing labor, fuel, and machine maintenance costs, many farmers still fear it. Why? The first thing growers fear the most is that it takes a long time to see results. Unfortunately, when switching to no-plow farming, we will not see immediate changes in the field. This takes time measured in months, sometimes even years. According to many farmers, transitioning to no-plow farming is associated with an increase in field weed infestations, a higher number of pests, and increased plant diseases. Farmers' concerns are justified, but the truth is that in the future, more and more farms will forego traditional farming because it is ultimately less profitable. That is why it is worth taking an interest in the offer of modern agricultural machinery manufacturers today. A perfect example is Rolmako, a company that meets the needs of farmers worldwide. A wide range of durable and economical agricultural machines, such as no-plow cultivators, chisel plows, disc harrows, or mulching harrows, will help in transitioning to no-plow farming. When opting for no-plow farming, consider the chisel plow from Rolmako, which allows for shorter working time needed for cultivation. Compared to a traditional plow, this machine will achieve excellent results. Using the chisel plow from Rolmako, we will quickly nourish the soil, leading to plant growth. The soil after the chisel plow work will be loosened and leveled, ready for sowing. The three-row no-plow cultivator is often used on light and sandy soils, while chisel plows are more suitable for heavier and clay soils. The cultivator works at a depth of up to 35 cm. It successfully replaces the plow as well as the chisel plow, whose depth range can reach up to 65 cm, where it also operates as a subsoiler. The appropriate choice of tool can help maintain soil structure and prevent degradation. No-plow farming: facts and myths. There are many myths surrounding no-plow farming. One of them is the statement that only by plowing are we able to mix the soil and achieve high yields. It is not true. Plowing destroys the soil and excessively aerates it, which not only leads to the burning of organic matter necessary for proper plant growth, but also significantly dries out the soil. That is why modern farms have long since switched to a no-plow farming system. The myths concern weeds, pests, and plant diseases. We often hear, "No-plow soils are heavily weed infested and require the use of glyphosate or other pesticides." The number of pests in no-plow soils is so high that it's difficult to deal with them. The same goes for plant diseases. All of this is true, but it's worth looking at it from a different perspective. Crop residues left in the field improve soil moisture and help reduce pathogens. While no-plow farming can increase the number of pests, it also increases the number of their natural enemies. As for diseases, No plow farming may lead to soil-borne diseases, but leaf and spike fungal diseases are less frequently observed. No plow farming is a developing agricultural practice that has both advantages and disadvantages. In response to the need to support farmers in transforming their activities to be more sustainable, pro-ecological initiatives are emerging. One such initiative within the framework of the strategic plan for the common agricultural policy is eco-schemes. Eco-schemes are an opportunity for many farmers to earn extra income. EU funds support nature-friendly farms. Actions taken by farmers for the environment and climate are intended to be a stimulus to implement modern solutions on their farms. It is worth considering the introduction of simplified plowless and strip-till farming, not only because they prevent erosion, improve soil quality, or reduce the amount of exhaust emissions entering the atmosphere. By implementing such methods, additional money can be earned per hectare covered by this farming system. Farmers who decide to adopt simplified farming systems under the eco scheme will have to replace the traditional plow with other tools such as a disc harrow, cultivator, or chisel plow. These and many other farming tools can be found in Rolmako's offer. So let's summarize everything I said earlier. Although the implementation of alternative farming methods is time-consuming and initially requires large financial investments, in the long run it brings only benefits. In reality, there is no one solution, and anyone who expects that changing the farming model will be a remedy for all the agricultural issues is mistaken. Instead of looking for problems, it is better to focus on finding solutions. Check out the no-plow farming machines from Rolmako and see for yourself that no-plow farming is not as daunting as sometimes portrayed. If you wish to gain valuable information today about proper soil care, saving time and money on fuel consumption, we warmly invite you to visit our website rolmako.com reduced tillage. There we discuss in detail various conservation tillage systems, such as no-plow farming. However, what is worth highlighting are not just the theoretical descriptions, but also practical tips illustrated with graphics that will help you better understand how the most commonly used machine combinations that simplify the farming process work. You will find not only descriptions of various farming systems, but also practical advice on their effective implementation on your farm. Our goal is not only to provide you with knowledge, but also to assist in its practical application in your daily farming work. Thanks to our publication, you will be able to make more informed decisions regarding choosing the best solutions for your farm. We cordially invite you to familiarize yourself with our content and discover how we can help you achieve success in farming.